And who are you, O great mountain? Some great mountain, some great problem in your life, some Goliath that has to be slain. Well, this is what it's talking about here. You're this great mountain before Zerubbabel, you shall become a plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone. Now there was a Zerubbabel type in this end time who did bring forth the headstone. I mean, he brought it forth and he preached the gospel around the world because God empowered him and he learned the lesson. This is that inset I was talking about. He learned the lesson that the seventh era ought to learn from him, that he brought forth the headstone because he didn't rely on human might or human power or human talent, but by the Spirit and power of God. And there was not any mountain that could stand before him. I mean, a tall obstacle and trial and test, nothing could stop him. And God just made those mountains plains. That has happened in this end time, and it's already happened. And that man has come and gone. So we have to bring forth the headstone. We have to bring forth the stone of help. Bring it forth. There's all kinds of power there. And unbelievable understanding and wisdom and joy and excitement. If we only bring forth the headstone the way Samuel did. And he certainly did do that. Now we have material on the Holy Spirit and repentance to tell you how to do that. And we'll mention those to you at the end of this program. But I might just paraphrase this, that stone, you can read in the Bible study aids, and it will tell you it's the chief or the leader, the head of the church, in other words, Jesus Christ himself. And then verse 9, the hands of Zerubbabel has laid the foundation of this house. His hand shall also finish it. You shall know that the Eternal of Hosts has sent me unto you. See here. God says, you're going to know that little remnant, that where God's work is and God's people are, they're going to know that God sent this end times Zerubbabel. They're going to know that. You know why? Well, because they know God. If you don't know God, can you know this? Or if you don't know this, do you know God? Maybe that's a better way to ask the question. We are going to have to ask some hard questions because it says here, God sent a man, a Zerubbabel type, in this end time, and he brought forth the headstone. And he showed us how to do it. Showed all of us how to do it. Verse 10. For who has despised the day of small things? For they shall rejoice and shall see the plummet in the hand of Zerubbabel with those seven. They are the eyes of the Eternal which run to and fro through the whole earth. You see, here this man had a plummet and he was able to measure correctly, spiritually. And there are those seven eyes again and they just run forth through all the earth. I mean, you can see what's going on in the world. You can see what's going on in the world and in your own life because God says, I will give you eyes. I will give you light. And I'll give everybody light that really wants light. They'll be able to see and not be in darkness and have all these problems and all these difficulties and not know how to solve them. I mean, God says if we know Him, we're going to solve problems. Well, you can see that it's all about those seven eras. About measuring for God. And then I'll just conclude with verse 11. It talks about these two olive trees. And then that's God the Father and Jesus Christ again. And then verse 12 talks about, and I answered again and said unto him, what be these two olive branches? Which through the two golden pipes empty the golden oil out of themselves. So this new revelation comes through those two olive branches. Well, who are they? What does that mean? Can we know? Well, we certainly can. Those two olive trees are God the Father and Jesus Christ, but you have two olive branches, two men that are anointed, God says, His anointed servants, and He lets that oil flow through them, and you have all kinds of new revelation coming through those two men in this end time, one over the sixth era and one over the seventh era. Notice verse 13, and he answered me and said, know you not what these be? And I said, no, my Lord. He didn't, again, Zechariah did not understand. Man can't understand this. You can't understand it. You can't figure it out yourself, though men think they can. The stone of help has to reveal it to us. Notice verse 14. Then said he, these are the two anointed ones that stand by the Lord of the whole earth. Two men that have all of this revelation that stand before the Lord of the whole earth. I mean, it's always a worldwide work because they stand by God, by that stone of help. Men can't do anything. We're all powerless and weak and can do nothing of ourselves. Even Jesus Christ said, I can't of my own self do nothing. But this stone, this powerful stone of help will move mountains out of your way. God said he'll, like with Zerubbabel, he'll just make them plains. Now that, you see, that is that stone of help that God wants to give us. And he wants to give us this golden oil. I mean, it's golden. Everything about it is golden. It just lights up your life and it lights up everything that you need to understand. So why is God letting all these terrible things happen in the world today? Why is He doing that? So we can learn to look to that stone of help. Listen, either we learn the lesson of Shiloh, or it seems to me that it's prophesied that we're going to suffer like Shiloh did. So we'd better all take note of this and accept the wonderful blessings God is giving us. Until next week, this is Gerald Flurry. Goodbye, friends.
Request our free book, The God Family Vision, our free booklet, Repentance Towards God, and our free correspondence course lesson on why you need the Holy Spirit. Christ came to earth to declare the Father, the God family. He didn't come here to declare Himself, as this world believes. That deception is why this world doesn't understand God's plan for mankind. They're in the dark, and so are most of God's own people. Here is the only message that will fill us with hope. It's about bringing God's government and peace to the whole universe. It's the true gospel that mankind has never understood. You need this vital understanding to make real and lasting changes in your life. Today's free literature will help you see the path to conquering your problems and trials. Be sure to also request a free subscription to our news magazine, The Philadelphia Trumpet. The Trumpet magazine will show you the meaning behind today's trends so you can understand your world. The print edition of The Trumpet magazine will keep you up to date on today's most important news events. Request your free subscription today. Request our free book, The God Family Vision, our free booklet, Repentance Towards God, and our free correspondence course lesson on why you need the Holy Spirit, along with The Trumpet magazine. Also, log on to thetrumpet.com for daily articles and headlines. All of our literature is free and will be sent to you with no cost or obligation. Order your free literature now. For the free literature, click on the Request Menu option. The preceding program and all literature were produced and sponsored by the Philadelphia Church of God.